Hello, I'm Jong-yeon Park from Duri Dental Clinic. Today, we're going to talk about treatment planning of the edentulous mandible. The mandible side, lip support is not as important as the maxillary side, so rather than that space, the residual bone is the focus of classification. So compared to maxillary side, mandible, relatively, the edentulous restoration is easier. This is because, you know, bone quality is mostly better here and that less impacted from the facial form, which means there are less things to be considered. So first, let's look at where sufficient bone is there and space is less than 11 meters, where the indication for fixed prosthesis. Next is overdenture, hybrid, hygienic, and other options available where bone is sufficient, but the space is about 12 to 14 millimeters. And thirdly, IARPD indication, which is where's the less bone on the posterior side and the space is less than 11 millimeters. And fourthly, overdenture, where there's less bone on the posterior side and space is about 12 to 14 millimeters. And lastly, where it's for overdenture, where space is more than 15 millimeters. So first, where you have sufficient bone and space is less than 11 millimeters. So if you have looked at the previous lectures, you probably can guess what I'm now going to say. With the premolar as the base, if it's less than 11 millimeters, then it's an indication for fixed prosthesis. So here, my recommendation is not to do overdenture. 8 implants can be used and can be restored with 3 segments. That's what I mostly do. The space is being insufficient, but overdenture was done at another clinic and came to me with the continuous fracture. He felt a lot of discomfort and the number 43 implant moved, so I had to remove that. And with 3 fists, I changed to fixed prosthesis, and the patient could recover stable chewing. So on the anterior side, 4 implants were splinted, and posterior split by 2, and restoration with 3 segments is also possible. Like for edentulous patient, in the place where I want, not always bone is available. So where bone is available, you have to place implant, and then you design without cantilever as much as possible. 4 at the front splinted, on the back 2 splinted. So don't you know, fix the idea where to place implant. Look at where you can remove a cantilever, and we have a lot of remaining bone and restore there. I think that could be a better option. So up to first molar is restored, then you could actually place 6 implant. In this case, 3 segment is what I mostly use for prosthesis. Placed 6 implant, and with 3 pieces, I segmented and did the final prosthesis. 6 implant, after placing them, all splinting them could be consideration, but it's very hard to make, and maintenance is also tricky. So recently, I segment mostly with 3 pieces. That would be my top go-to approach. When I in my residency in 2008, I did this case. That's where I thought splinting was the most favorable result. After 8 years recall, it's maintained quite well. But if I'm going back to 2006, I would do 3-piece segments and make the prosthesis. four implants, if you only place that, then one piece prosthesis can be considered. Economically, it might be viable, but it's hard to make and there could be risk of misfit and maintenance is so tricky. So I try to avoid this design much as possible. If you do fixed restoration, the minimum six implant placement seems to deliver the most favorable result. In 2014, using four implants, one piece fixed prosthesis was done, and after 6 years, it still maintained very well. But I do believe this was not best option looking back. Now, fixed on the mandibular side, I think six is the minimum number. That's always what I explain to the patient. This type of prosthesis for patient might be good, but if there is a problem for surgeons, it's very hard to solve them, and the making process at the lab is also very difficult. So I always wonder, who is this for? For patient, economically, yes, six or four patient. For patient, I believe it's the same. But if you look at how to maintain them, which is the dentist's responsibility, it's very unfavorable design. So for patient, due to economic reasons, if he wants only four implants, then this would be the restoration approach. Symmetrically, two on each side, then two-piece segmented and create fixed prosthesis, and on other areas, I restore with RPD. This is because these days, health insurance covers RPD, so it has become very attractive treatment option. It's a case I've already shown you. In insufficient space, using overdenture is the not very good option. It was done at another dentist, but there was a lot of fracture and problems. So on the lower side, switch to fixed prosthesis. Then on the mandible, there was no problem. Also, if due to economic consideration, restoration done, then overdentition, implant class RPD, I believe, is the better option. So as you can see in this case, if there's, you know, loss of tissue is not large, economically, implant class RPD could be better option economically considered, when you consider economic viability. If you have sufficient bone and space is 12 to 14 millimeters, then these are the cases. Patient, if wants fixed prosthesis, then if it doesn't impact smile line, or even if there's a smile line impact, if you sacrifice aesthetic, I would prefer hygienic type. If the abutment is, you know, visible in the smile line, then patient might not want that. Then if patient refuse strongly, then inevitably on the abutment side, you treat it with pink porcelain, or you have to go with hybrid type. But if with the patient with through sufficient communication, designing with hygienic type in terms of long-term maintenance, I think it's more favorable. So patients showing metal abutment in smiling do not want that, then, you know, you could never they have to go with hybrid type. This is prosthesis with hybrid type for 7 years. It's really maintained very well, but still oral hygiene management is tricky. So I don't really strongly recommend hybrid type to patient, and if possible, I try to recommend restoring with hygienic type. If facial form needs to be improved, then using removable on the anterior might be an option. So if there's insufficient bone and anterior space is 9 to 11 millimeters. So on the anterior side, placed implant and the posterior restoring with RPD could be a good option. On the mandible side, four fixtures in the mental foramen, and on posterior side, I used RPD. On the mental foramen, four fixture was placed, and restoring with RPD is what I actively use. Between mental foramen, there is no anatomical structure, so you can place implant day, and for aged patient, rather than, you know, doing risky bone grafting in the current bone conditions, doing easily, like this option is what I opt for. Even if there is a remaining bone on the backside, sometimes they want less number of implants due to economic reasons. So just restoring only up to a premolar molar is also a viable option. If the opposing teeth is like this, then cantilever could be an option. For aged patient, I try to avoid bone grafting as much as possible. For narrow bone, if you can do alveolar flattening, then you could actually place bone in the existing, place implant in the existing bone. After flattening, I placed the implant on the backside. I used RPD restoration. So he wanted to continue the denture on the maxillary side, so I didn't make it again. Next is when there is insufficient posterior bone and restoration space is about 12 to 14 millimeters. So in this case, a unifacial form improvement. So over denture, I also believe is the most general option. But still, unlike the maxillary side, lip support is less important on the mandible side. So place implant on the anterior side and using RPD with a restoration could be an option. Implant class RPD, the mandible side where there's a lot of tissue loss, I believe is a viable option. Of course, in the facial form, there is some sacrifice, so it's a compromise, but I believe still it's a possible restoration option. Lastly, let's look at where there is an insufficient posterior bone and space is more than 15 millimeters. So to improve facial form, over denture on the mandible side, I believe is the best option. Located with the solitaire, bowel overdenture that can be splitted would be better option. So it's a case I slightly regret. This was done actually in 2011 with hybrid type. I did the prosthesis. I thought the patient would be happy and I thought it was rather well done. On the short term, it looks good, but you know, patient was over than 90 years old. So maintaining with this type of prosthesis or a hygiene was something I did not really consider. There's a high likelihood that the long-term result might be bad. So rather than this hybrid type, like this one now, hygienic type, which is easy for hygiene for a long term for patient as well as the surgeon, it might be better option. But because of SMILE 9, there could be aesthetic issues, so you have to talk with patients a lot and there should be sufficient assessment about the SMILE 9. The anterior side, if there's no bone to place implant, then full denture might be the only option. And the full denture on the mandible side is very hard to, give satisfaction to a patient. So rather than full denture, just placing even two implants is be helpful to the patient as well as to the surgeon. So summary. If sufficient remaining bone is there and space is less than 11 millimeters, then fixed prosthesis and implant class RPD would be good approach. If there's sufficient bone, space is within 12 to 14 millimeters, then hygienic, hybrid type, fixed prosthesis, implant class RPD, over denture. So in this case, you can have wide range of options available depending on patient's requirements and economic conditions. You can choose one option. And if there's insufficient posterior bone and you can only place implant on the anterior side and space there is 11 or less, then like these three options could be chosen. And if there's insufficient posterior bone and the space is 12 to 14, then over denture and implant class RPD could be an option. Lastly, if there's insufficient posterior bone and restoration space is more than 15 millimeters, then hybrid type fixed prosthesis can be considered. Then here, you need to find a must where design that can be favorable for oral hygiene management. And if smile line wise is possible, then hygienic type would be the most favorable in terms of result because it's easy to maintain oral hygiene. And complete denture is really challenging. So on the anterior side, just placing two fixture, whether it's possible, needs to be looked at. And if possible, do over denture with that. That would be the most favorable result. Now, this is the end of this lecture. We looked at the edentulous mandible treatment plan and restoration here. You have less impact from facial form. So if the patient wants fixed prosthesis, they might be easier than maxillary side. And bone quality is mostly better here. So if you're doing restoration for the first time, it's better to start with the mandible side. So if you improve your skills, then you will have more successful implant with time. I'll see you at the next lecture. Thank you very much.